We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Doomsday Clock, issue 12. This is the final installment of the Doomsday Clock miniseries, finally. Written by Geoff Johns, art by Gary Frank, color by Brad Anderson, letters by Rob Leigh, cover and variant cover by Gary Frank and Brad Anderson, associate editor Amadeo Tuturo, and editor was Brian Cunningham. Alright, so everything comes to a massive conclusion as tons of villains descend on Superman, and Dr. Manhattan has to make some choices, as does Superman. And it's really interesting the way this plans out, because a lot of the stuff that happened at the beginning of Rebirth that we thought we knew about how they were formatting the universe is changed here. And honestly, I thought they fixed a lot of problems with the DCU that I was having with Rebirth and New 52. But there is some interesting things being set up here. There's mentions of a universe that hasn't been explored yet, and that some of us older fans will know, and we also learned about an upcoming crisis, and they hint at the new Earth 5G, which is probably just going to annoy me based on what I've heard of it. There's some really cool stuff in here that happens that I don't want to spoil for anyone going to read this, but this is definitely setting up future events for the DCU in the last half of the book. So I think some of what the delays may have been was to iron out some of the changes, either to alter them for what's coming up, you know, to adjust according to the new plan, or to kind of wait till certain events happened in the books. That may have been some of the delays. I don't think it was all of them, but it was definitely some of them. Now, the art in here is very, very good. I really like Frank's art. I think he's a very talented artist, and you get to see that in a lot of these big splash pages, and the storytelling is done very well. I'm really glad by the return of some of the heroes that we see in here. That is really awesome and makes me very happy. Some of the changes that are coming from DC are probably going to annoy the crap out of me, but this book was amazing. There's a lot of fan service in here. There's a lot of references to old properties, not only Nathaniel Dusk, but the Silver Blade is mentioned. We learn the fate of the Justice Society. The only thing I really didn't like in here was the fact that a couple of the Watchmen characters hang around. I don't particularly care for that, but that's a very minor quibble. Overall, this was a really, really good end cap to the series. I thought it really worked, and it was definitely a solid issue. It's a terrible spot to jump in because it will make no sense if you haven't read the entire miniseries. But I will recommend the entire miniseries because overall I thought it was very solid and it's consistent. And Geoff Johns is a very good writer when he has passion for it. And I think some of this stuff that they mentioned coming up is probably forced upon him, but it's well done. And I think they are hinting at several future crises that are planned out coming up in 2020 and in 2025 that I hope are done well. I'm always hoping for good stories, of course, and this was a good story, so I'm definitely going to recommend this series. I know they're releasing the book in two hardbacks, the first six issues in one book that's already out, and the other six will be in another hardcover. I would wait till it's all in one, get like the absolute edition. It'll be worth the extra money. I'm one of the few people, I think, that actually thought they handled the Watchmen characters very well, and that it treated them with respect, just like it treated the DC Universe characters with the same respect. And I am glad that some of the stuff that's in this is in here, because I was really worried in the first 11 issues that certain things would not come to pass, but they do in this, and it really tied everything up pretty well, and I'm real happy with that. So Geoff Johns and Gary Frank did an amazing job, and I'm definitely going to recommend this issue as well as the entire series. That's just my opinion, though. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.